What would you say to people who would ask this question? If the president has nothing to hide about his health profile, why would he object to this?
You must remember that when this was done, where was President Zuma when this was done? He was in prison.
Yes.
This is exactly the reason why a criminal case should not be heard when a person is not in court, exactly for these reasons.
Well, let's hear then what his advocate said in response to the judge.
Once they receive the report, to appoint a medical practitioner to examine Mr. Zuma, I take it you don't have a difficulty with that either.
Well, I don't have a difficulty, my lord. I don't know about the doctors. Again, we leave that to the doctors. But and as I understand it, if the state has any issues with the report, the state is then entitled. Because, as I say, neither myself nor Mr. Trengove, unfortunately, are medical experts. So he would hardly be able to cross-examine anyone if he has not had access to his own medical team.
So no direct objection from the president's counsel. Was he briefed on the matter?
No. You heard what he said. It was very clear. He said, I think what you should have used, if you wanted to use a counter, is to have Advocate Mpofu saying, I have spoken to the client and I've got direct instructions to articulate myself this way. Yeah. So Advocate Mpofu was very clear on this matter.
Yes.
That the way he sees it, in fact, I think you're missing the sarcasm, because I think that response by Advocate Mpofu is quite sarcastic, that who is Advocate, who's Vim,
yes,
Trengove, to second-guess that thing and want to cross-question a medical practitioner. It's actually a sarcastic argument, which is actually in line with the posture that President Zuma would take.
Let's come back to my question then, Mr. Manyi, and just to conclude, what do you say to people who would say if President Jacob Zuma has no reason to hide anything in regard to his medical condition, which he has brought to the court, not the other way around, why would he object to independent doctors examining him? It's a second opinion, they would argue, not second guessing. Second opinions are extremely common in medical matters.
But I did explain this. Must I repeat myself? Let me repeat myself. President Zuma is saying, when it agrees and saying I am sick, everybody accepts agrees version, no second opinion by NPA. And this,
yes,
has happened in the country. Now President Zuma says, this is the situation, and I've indicated three times where an impression is given that we don't believe what we're saying. So why what's the problem with his attitude? Because his attitude is informed by how he gets dealt with. I mean, even the constitutional court of this country decided that, okay, now that it's President Zuma,
yes,
we're going to dispense of normal procedures, and this is extraordinary. And then they went into arbitrary ground. Why is it that when President Zuma is involved, that normal processes and procedures don't seem to be sufficient, that some extraordinary stuff must come in? Why is this? We are tired of Zuma laws. We,
yes,
are tired of laws and procedures constructed precisely to deal with President Zuma.
News.
Experts.
Analysis.
Where things stand.
What you need to know. Drive home with John Pellman.
On 702.